perhaps after prolonged stress, these RNA stress granules turn into aggregates, perhaps the acrylamide domains, as the Gipper lab and others have suggested. So we operate under this hypothesis, and in order to test this hypothesis, we took a candidate gene approach, and we started testing for functional interactions between TDP43 and other RNA binding proteins. And the one we began with is fragile X protein, or FMRP, which has been traditionally linked to cognitive dysfunction. But if you look at its function in RNA metabolism, it does everything, it does pretty much everything else that TDP43 does. So in order to begin to test this functional interaction, we used a Drosophila model that we developed in my lab based on TDP43 overexpression. And I don't have time to tell you all about this model, but essentially it recapitulates several aspects of ALS pathology, one of which is neurodegeneration in the retina. So overexpression of TDP43 in the retina, either wild type or mutant, leads to depigmentation. So these white spots are representative of neural death. And we know that because we can section through the retina and see that very clearly. When we modulate FMRP dosage, in this case, we reduce FMRP by knockdown in the neural, in the retina. We see increased depigmentation consistent with an enhancement. While when we overexpress FMRP, we see a protective effect with neurodegeneration almost completely going away. How about a different model, like motor neurons? In order to test locomotor function, we use a behavioral assay called larval turning. And essentially, we let the larvae crawl, and then we turn the belly up, and then we count how long it takes for these larvae to go back to their normal position and start crawling again. Overexpression of either wild type or mutant TDP leads to an increased larval turning time, as shown here, and knockdown of FMRP by RNAi enhances this time, while overexpression of FMRP reduces this time almost to control levels.